How's your bottom, Sid?
The swelling's gone down, but I still got to sit on one cheek.
I still don't understand what a wasp was doing in the wardrobe at this time of year.
I do. He was having a kip in my trousers.
Well, you must have provoked him.
I simply put my left leg down one side, the right leg down the other, pull up the zip, and...
Why don't you go out for a nice long walk or something? Blow the cobwebs away.
I haven't got any cobwebs.
You will have if you sit there much longer.
There she is, Moby Dick.
Can't stop long. Trevor's taking us to the zoo.
Oh, that'll be nice, Betty. We used to go there when we were courting. We often used to sit on the grass and share a packet of monkey nuts.
I'm very sorry, but we've run clean out of monkey nuts. We could sell you a couple of bananas.
Sid,
we were thinking of taking sandwiches.
Bread.
But we've run out of bread.
Oh, we've got plenty. Don't worry. I didn't know Trevor was keen on animals.
Oh, yes, he used to keep a pet monkey before he married me.
That was a fair swap.
Pardon?
Nothing.
Trevor was telling me that some people get so keen on their pets that when they die, they have them stuffed.
That's what my family's going to do with me.
Well, the way you move about, nobody would notice the difference.
Well, I must be off.
Must you?
Well, if there is a spare cup going.
No, don't keep the monkeys waiting.
Bye.
Isn't it romantic?
What, you and me alone in the kitchen?
No. Betty and Trevor revisiting the place they did their courting.
What is romantic about the two of them standing there chewing nuts in front of a cage full of monkeys all scratching each other?
You have no heart.
Morning.
Hello. Morning, dear. Would you like a cup of tea?
Yes, please, Mummy. I thought I'd take Betty's baby out for a walk.
Oh, she just popped in. They've all gone to the zoo.
Yep. They're going to stand there eating monkey nut sandwiches in front of their relations.
That is not kind.
You're dead right. Just imagine how those poor monkeys must feel.
Oh, answer that, would you, dear?
Answer what?
The telephone.
It's probably a wrong number.
You'll never know unless you pick it up.
All right. Oh, yeah.
He's not very energetic this morning, is he?
If he gets much slower, he'll take root.
Well, he's managed to lift the phone.
So long as it doesn't sprain his wrist.
Wrong number. I got the post here. No gas. That's yours.
Thank you.
Electricity bill, that's yours.
Thank you.
Hello, what's this? Gluckstein and O'Reilly, solicitors. Dear sir, please call round at this office at your earliest convenience. How about that?
How about what?
Old Uncle Percy snuffed it. My Uncle Percy, my dad's eldest brother.
Oh, that is old.
Is that the Uncle Percy who was so tight with money?
That's it. Sent us a tin toast rack for our boat when we got married.
With Cardoma Cafe stamped on it.
That's it, yeah. And two pieces of toast still stuck in it.
Have you left you some money, then?
Well, blimey. Never spent any. Must have left it to someone.
How much do you think it'll be?
Well, I don't know, but every little bit helps. Good old Uncle Purse.
Sid.
Well, blimey, they wouldn't want any long faces. He had a lovely sense of humour, the old boy.
What was he like?
Well, he had a wooden leg and a parrot and he used to write poetry. And he was mad about Treasure Island. He must have read it to me 48 times. He used to walk around dressed like Long John Silver. Even had his picture taken like that as a Christmas card. and send it to everybody for Christmas.
He sounds nice.
He was potty.
How did he die?
Says here, after an accident. Hope it wasn't his usual accident.
What was that?
Well, as soon as he'd had a few, he'd start staggering about and slipping off his wooden leg.
How old was he?
93.
Oh, well, he had a good run.
Yeah. Mind you, he knew what it was to suffer.
Poor old man.
Yeah, he had woodworm twice.
Poor old Uncle Percy.
So, while you're out, get some lovely flowers, will you, darling?
For the funeral?
No, no, for your mother. She's upset.
So what happened then?
Well, that's about it. He phoned the solicitor and then dashed out.
Would you like a snack while we're waiting for your father?
Please, Mummy.
Oh, yes, I'd quite like some caviar on toast and a glass of champagne.
Right, that's two teas and a couple of cheese sandwiches.
Thanks a lot.
Mike!
Yeah?
Give me a hand with a ladder.
What?
The ladder. The ladder to get up into the attic.
Well, why do you want to get up into the attic?
You remember I told you about Uncle Percy and Treasure Island?
Yes.
And a Christmas card of him dressed as Long John Silver?
Mm-hmm.
It's all in the will, and I got a copy here. Here we go. Although I had a wooden leg, it never stopped me pleasures. They used to call me Long John Silver, and I've had some little treasures. And now that I am at the end of the plank that they call life, one thing I'm bloody pleased about, I never had a wife. Yeah, old Percy wasn't so mad after all, was he?
See.
Well, I told you he had a great sense of humour, didn't I? That's not all. Listen. And now I feel the end is near. See how my candle flickers. But I don't give a monkey's nut. I shout farewell and knickers. Yes. After that, his writing gets a bit blurred.
Just as well.
Now, hang on. This is the important bit. Therefore, having no other relatives, if my favourite nephew, Sidney Abbott, produces the aforesaid photograph of myself, then for such an act of faith, he shall be amply rewarded.
Oh, see!
Dad, come back up!
Yeah, no. There, see that? And that photograph is up in my old album in the attic.
Are you sure?
100%. Come on, Mike.
Oh!
Right.
Come on, up here.
How did he die, Sid?
Well, he was hopping after a bus. The bus stopped suddenly and he went smack into the back of it.
How sad.
And he was only going three stops.
You certainly have collected a load of old rubbish in your time.
This is not a load of old rubbish. This is part of our heritage. One day all this will be yours.
I can't wait.
Is this it, Daddy?
That's it! Bring it over here. That's it. There we are. Sidney Abbott.
Oh, Sidney Abbott, Class 4, Scraggs Road, Modern. I thought you said you went to grammar school.
I said I almost went to grammar school.
Well, you wouldn't have got there on your spelling.
Why not? What do you mean?
There's no K in school.
Oh, no, no, no. That's speed writing.
Oh, look, it's that girl with her skirt up waving.
What girl?
It's all right. It's all right. It's just a knobbly knees contest. Hang on a minute. Let me get this. Hold up.
Oh! Sid, look. Look. There's a picture of you in your shorts.
Yeah, I just finished the high jump.
You don't look very pleased about it.
No, well, I only got one leg over.
That's my dad.
It's not funny. It was very painful. Now, Uncle Percy's got to be in here somewhere. Wait a minute. Hang on. It's missing.
Well, how can it be missing?
What do you mean it's missing?
It's missing. That's where it should be. There. Where'd you pick it up?
Over here.
Well, it must have fallen out while you were looking for it. Come on now. Hold that, darling, will you? Mind where you put your feet. Are you sure you found it round here?
I'm positive, Daddy. It was right next to this conker.
God, blimey. That's Billy Baxter's conker.
Well, I'm sure he won't miss it after all these years.
No, 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 you don't understand. That's what happened to the photograph.
Well, what's it got to do with Billy Baxter?
Well, he was also raving mad about Treasure Island, so I swapped Uncle Percy for his conker.
Where does he live?
That was over 40 years ago.
If you put your mind to it, I'm sure you can find him.
I know where to find him.
Where?
P Plot 37, Wandsworth Cemetery.
Well, look, can't you explain to the solicitor that you swapped it, but you were very young at the time and you'll never do it again, and if he gives you another chance...
Don't go on.
I'm sorry, sir. I mean, I'm only trying to help.
I know you are, but there's nothing we can do.
Hang on. I've got it.
What?
Well, you borrow my camera.
Yeah.
Right? You take a photograph of nothing.
Yeah.
Whistle it round at the solicitor, and you tell him your uncle was on it, but it's faded. I suppose, you haven't got any other uncles who dress up, have you?
God forbid.
Oh, that's a pity. Wait a minute, hang on.
Yeah.
There's a fella at work, he dresses up.
Is he?
Yeah, but he's different.
I bet he is.
No, I mean he's in the amateur dramatics.
How very uninteresting.
But he could help, you see. I mean, he's always doing the Pirates of Penzance. I mean, God blimey, he does a Whitsun and Easter and Christmas.
Wait a minute. Pirates of Penzance?
Yeah. I mean, when you see one pirate, you've seen them all, haven't you?
Trevor, I love you. There are times where you, without any sense at all, without even thinking, quite unconsciously, you make sense.
Well, what have I said?
Nothing. Bring it up quick. Come on. No, sweetheart, that's naughty. No, stop nibbling at my ear. All right, now, darling, now you just sit still while your Uncle Sidney hangs up his trousers. And if you're good, you get a lovely surprise. No, I'll never get it.
Perhaps it's because I'm here watching, Sid.
Could be. There's always a first time. All right, I'll tell you what, Chris. We'll have a go with you sitting on the chair.
Well, I don't think it'll work, sir. I mean, I tried it with Betty once, and it was a funny angle.
Will you just lean back, and just don't breathe so heavy.
Right, here I go.
Oh. No, not you, darling. No, Trevor. All right, now let's get it over. Come on, Jean, I'll go really mad if she finds I've got a bird up here in the bedroom.
Well, I think it's dishonest dressing up as a pirate.
But what's dishonest about it? It's only a photograph.
Yes, and I think it's very good of Daddy to go to all that trouble. After all, he is thinking of us.
Well, I hope Uncle Percy thinks so.
Here he is.
It worked!
Well done, Daddy!
The silly old lady didn't even notice it was the wrong leg.
Sid, how much will we get?
No, hang on.
Are we very rich?
Well, it depends. He didn't actually leave us any cash, but he's left her his most treasured possessions.
2 dozen tin toast racks.
Could be anything. Gold, silver, oil paintings. Listen to this. And to my favourite nephew, Sidney Abbott, the contents of the 2 large packing cases and a small parcel. That can't be bad, can it? That's him. That must be that. Excuse me.
Morning.
Morning, Mr. Abbott.
That's it.
Sign here, please.
One large packing case. Small packing case. One small parcel. Hang on, mate. Here we are. A fiver for you.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure.
Blooming heavy they are and all.
They're heavy?
The kangaroo ain't bad, but the monkey's murder.
Aren't you getting tired of holding that bloody tree up? No good you begging, mate. You're getting nothing.
Sid, I still can't believe it.
You can't believe it? Come and have another look.
Why couldn't you leave them in the cases and put them in the garage?
Because of the pirate's curse.
What pirate's curse?
The one that was round the kangaroo's neck.
Why would he want to put a curse on them?
In case they fall into the wrong hands.
Well, I think the whole thing's silly.
Silly or not, I'm not going against this curse. I'll read it to you again. Now, you listen to this. If these my pets are stored away and end up with the mice, the perpetrator of this deed will pay a dreadful price. Not only will his hair fall out and all his teeth go black, his knees will knock together and he'll find he's lost the knack. And I don't want that to happen to me. Thank you very much.
A monkey, a kangaroo, and a pigeon.
It's not my fault, is it?
What happened to all the gold coins you were talking about?
Well, he probably spent all his money on some bird.
He was 93.
He could hop after a bus. He must have had some energy.
Well, I know one thing. Curse or no curse, I'm not going to spend another day with that monkey staring at me. He gives me the willies. I keep thinking he's going to jump on me.
How can he jump on you? He's been stuffed.
Well, close the door and then he can't see me.
Oh, God. I'm doing my best to get rid of the blubbing things. I've looked through this 50 times.
Well, you're not being very successful, are you?
Hang on, wait a minute. There's a fella here wants a 22-foot crocodile. We must be getting warmer.
And how is the great white hunter? Well, I don't know why we don't start our own zoo.
I did, with you. What's that? What's it?
Look what Cedric's done.
Oh, Cedric. You dirty boy, come here. Come on, get on there. Now keep away from Betty and her bleeding relations.
How long are they going to be here?
I've already told your mother I'm doing my best to get rid of the blooming things.
Well, I don't mind keeping the pigeon because he's got a pretty face. And my father used to keep them.
Yes, a lot of people keep pigeons.
I know, but how many people keep monkeys?
See?
Trevor. Trevor. Come here. Trevor and Betty, they're always going to the zoo.
You mean we could...
That's it. Shh. Yes, Trev? Come in, son. Oh, doesn't he look well? Nice to see you, son.
Is he?
Yes, nice to see him, isn't it? Always.
Oh, yes, Trevor, always.
Sit down, have a drink.
No, thanks, Sid. It's a bit early for me.
Well, of course it's a bit early for him. Would you like a cup of tea, Trevor?
Oh, yeah, I'd like a cup of tea. Yeah.
Well, sit down and I'll make you one.
Yeah, make yourself comfy.
That's it. Yeah. Right, well... I'm sorry to hear about your disappointment, Sid.
Yeah, well, that's all right. Yeah, you're fond of animals, aren't you?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, your lovely wife was round here yesterday. Told us that you used to have a pet monkey.
Yeah. He was a lovely little fella.
Yes?
Yeah, he used to chase all round the house.
Go on.
Yeah, sometimes it used to take me a couple of hours to catch him.
How do you fancy one that stands still?
You mean him?
Yeah, me.
Yeah, well, I would, Sid, but I've got Betty now.
Well, there's no answer to that, is there?
No, I wish I could help you out, Sid, but we'll have to think of something else.
Yeah, we will, won't we?
How are we doing, Sid?
We're not.
Look, why don't you try swapping it?
Don't talk to me about swapping. I used to do that at school. I never backed a winner. I once swapped a jar of tadpoles for a kiss.
Yeah.
It was shocking. Wish I kept the tadpoles.
Listen, Sid. Why don't you put them both back in the box and stick them in the back garden with a little sign saying, please take one?
No. People think of catching it, you see. People only take things when you don't want them to take them. I got it.
What?
We'll put them in the garden like you said, stick a bloody great sign on them saying, please do not take away.
Not take away?
And somebody will whip them.
Oh, that's dead clever, that is.
That's clever, yeah.
Wait a minute.
All right.
What about your Uncle Percy's curse?
Well, that's just it. Wherever the animals go, the curse goes with them. So if we ever see a fella walking around with no hair and black choppers,
we'll know who's got him. Come
on. Well, I hope they're having plenty of bright ideas.
Trevor's not very good at thinking. After about 5 minutes, his mind goes.
Jean!
They're home early. Either they put the clocks on or they've been thrown out of the pub.
Our problem is over.
You found someone to buy them?
Not exactly, no.
Well, what are you going to do with them?
Shh, never mind. Just leave it to us. Now then.
Yeah?
You take the little one. And I'll take Rolf Harris. Now, come on, what did you do? All right. Oh, here we are. Come on.
Hello, Sid. What you got there? The missus.
A kangaroo and a monkey.
I only asked.
Twit. Oh, very lovely, Sid.
You like it?
Yeah. Come on.
Have you seen your father?
Yes, that's why we came in the back way.
I was going to offer my help, but they seem to be doing rather well.
Look, Lionel.
I wouldn't do that again, see?
No, neither me.
What's going on?
Nothing. If you should wake up in the middle of the night and hear funny noises in the garden, just keep your noses out of it. They've gone.
You mean somebody stole them during the night?
Yes.
Well, you must ring the police.
No, we don't want to bring them into it.
What's going on?
Somebody stole the kangaroo and the monkey.
So it worked.
Yes, of course it worked. Stupid old twit, Uncle Percy.
Well, I'm glad we kept the pigeon, because he's got a pretty face.
What kind of pigeon is it?
I don't know. Sid, what kind of pigeon is it?
I've no idea.
It's got a little piece of paper around its leg.
Well, perhaps he was one of the ones that used to carry messages during the war.
Perhaps there's a message on this one.
It's a bit late, isn't it? The war's over.
Well, have a look at it.
What does it say?
Hang on. It's a message from Uncle Percy.
Well, what does it say?
Well, hang on a minute. It's very small. Just a minute. Dear Sydney, the kangaroo is a treasure trove, and if you've got the guts, you'll find another £1,000 where the monkey stuffs its nuts. I want the police. We'll find her. Police, I want to report a robbery. Yeah, a kangaroo and a monkey. That's it. No, he'll have no hair and black choppers. No. No, not the monkey, the fella. The bloke who took him. Yeah. So. There's a curse on him, yeah. But he was longer. Come here. Now, you keep my curse stored away and end up with your mind.
Sit,
I'm gone.